one point that is important. I think this is important.
I'll give you.
Please.
I'll give you time, Senator Warren.
Is that okay?
Warren,
okay.
Senator Warren ran for the Senate in order to escape interdepartmental.
I understand that, Senator.
I wanted to come to a place that was more collegiate.
That's right. So you should have time to, Senator Warren, I'll give you some extra time to finish your discussion.
The point I just wanted to add that's relevant to this is that no faculty member, to my view, would ever agree for their department to co-sponsor a talk by Richard Spencer. So we're really talking about apples and oranges here, and it's a public-private distinction that needs to be made. At these public universities, I think we're seeing these provocateurs seeking to set up talks that don't really have faculty sponsorship. So let the faculty lead, and I think we'll go in the right direction.
So let me just see if I can pull this back, though, to the point about what happens with free speech, whether it gets any special protection. And the notion that I just want to underline here is that people who attacked you get no special protection. Neither does the Charlottesville white supremacist who murdered a woman there, or the three white supremacists who tried to shoot people at the University of Florida last week. They will go to jail. Free speech is not about violence. It is not about silence. What I'm concerned about is that right now, it is all too easy for all of us to avoid hearing anything that we don't already agree with. And that's an enormous threat to our democracy. I know that powerful people want us divided, that foreign governments are pouring gasoline on that fire, flooding Facebook and Twitter with angry messages designed to stir up lingering resentments. The President of the United States is pouring even more gasoline on that fire, attacking our free press as a, quote, enemy of the people, and even threatening to use the awesome power of the government to shut down press outlets for reporting that he doesn't agree with. And I don't care what your politics are. All of us who believe in America and its freedoms need to work harder to put out that fire.